Welcome back to The Rhode Show. This morning in The Buzz, how does living a long and happy life sound to you? To me, it sounds pretty good. How about living to be 120 years old? Most people would say, no thanks. Scientists are now researching ways to slow down the aging process, creating treatments that might one day let people live much longer. But according to a study by the Pew Research Center, 56% of Americans wouldn't even want a treatment that would let them live to see 120. Americans consider the ideal lifespan to be between 79 and 100 years. Median age was 90 years old. Americans born today can't expect to live to just 79 on average. I say, let's try it. If I can live to be 120, I'm going to go for it.
Yeah?
I am.
79 seems kind of low. So you would live until 120?
Absolutely I could. If I was someone who, nowadays you see a lot of these people who are 100 years old, they don't look, first of all, they don't look 100 years old.
No.
They still have, you know, everything going on. They know what's going on. They're able to function and, you know, move around and stuff. If I could be 120 and be like that, absolutely. Why not?
I think it's about, like, keeping that healthy lifestyle throughout your life and keeping your brain active and...
We say this, you know, you got to live a healthy lifestyle. And I know this is bad to say. There are people who are into their hundreds, and I'm like, so, you know, you said, what did you do? I smoked every day. I did this. I drank coffee.
Who are you talking to? Who does that?
People do. And some, I don't know if they're just, you know, pickled or what, but that's what kept them alive. I don't know. I'm not, you know, saying you should, but they do.
Well, that's one avenue.
Would you
live to be 120?
Live to 120 if it was possible?
I have an issue with this in general. It's just that idea of like, oh, you know, it does come to an end at some point. And so you have to kind of think like, you know, would you want to pass away earlier or later? I don't know. I think I have a hard time with that issue of death in general, that it's hard to think about it. I guess I would want to say that I want to live a long life and be healthy. And I don't smoke cigarettes anyway, so
I don't think
I'm going to pick up that habit now to live longer. But I think that I just would want to be healthy and be surrounded by people that I love for the rest of my life.
But I think that's where a lot of people might question it, because you, of course, would have to say goodbye to a lot of people that you love if you are outliving many, many people that point. However, I've always been someone that I was like, I would love to make it to 100 just to say that I did it.
Right.
But it really, like, that
is so you, Michaela, too. Because you have a competitive streak and you're an athlete, and that's you.
Just so when she gets to 104, 105, going, yeah, in your face, so I beat you.
No, I'm saying me personally, like, how cool would that be to be like, I'm 100 years old?
Yes.
That is a really great feat.
If I can go to 120, you can go to 105, whatever.
You're going to be shooting hoops on your 100th birthday.
Oh, my God.
If you can do that, God bless you.
I just hope that, you know, everything.
Well, we put it out to our Facebook friends and our Twitter followers, too. And here's what some are saying. Ada Branco says, not sure I have a number in mind, but I'd like to be able to live a long, healthy life. All right, I'm with her. I'm about to turn 50.
Yeah,
go you. So if I'm considered midlife, 100 will be fine for me.
Sure.
And Jean Dunn Golden says, a healthy age. I don't want scientists messing anymore with my food, medicines, water, etc. She brings up a good point. Maybe we'd live longer if everything we consume wasn't artificial or had life-altering side effects.
Artificial stuff tastes so good.
It tastes so good. It really is. Those names you can't pronounce are fantastic.
Oh, Amanda Octo shares this with us. I want to increase the probability of being healthy as I age, so I'm not just surviving and suffering with ailments and illnesses I could have prevented by having a healthy lifestyle. Which could it be smoking cigarettes? Well, Deb Kulis Carmody tells us, as long as I'm needed by my loved ones, as long as I'm healthy, and as long as I want to be here, is how long she'd want to stay.